So I'm always going to start with the object that's closest to me. That's what I tend to pick. Closest to me and in the middle of the setup. From where I'm sitting, I can barely see the light hitting the lip of the top of that first cup. Barely see it on the other side, on the far side. So that's just barely below my eye level. And I'm pretty tall, so it might just be a flat line for you guys. I'm going to ignore the handle while I get the basic shape of it in there, because remember, we're going to simplify and then add in complexities.
Unfortunately, the camera that is set up behind me is slowly sinking, and so I do not capture all of my sight measuring, but hopefully this will give you a general idea of what I'm trying to do here.
So I'm comparing all of my measurements to that initial line that I put down, the initial measurement that I took of the front of the cup. And so everything else, every other measurement is based on a relationship to that measurement.
Fortunately, my camera finally fell, so I noticed that it wasn't filming correctly and I was able to reset it.
Don't forget, you can use like angles between objects to make sure like your heights are measured correctly, like the height of one object. Like right now I'm taking the height of the cylinder and comparing that angle from the top of the cylinder down to the closest corner to me of the cube. And that gives me an angle. So then I know that the top of my cylinder is going to be right here to match up with that corner of the cube. And don't forget, you still have that element of the fabric in the backdrop and in the foreground.
So now that I've gotten the basic shapes in without any shading or rendering, I want to stop and check my work to make sure that my proportions and angles and everything are all correct. So what I'm doing is I'm using an app called PicStitch, PicStitch. I'll link to it below in the description. I use that app. You can really use any kind of collage making app, where you can put photos next to each other or in like a grid. You drop your photos into a collage maker. And so that's what I'm doing is I take a photo of my still life setup from where I'm sitting, and then I take a photo of my drawing so far, and I put them side by side in the collage frame, so that they're basically the same size and position. And that really helps me check to make sure that I have everything correct in my drawing so far. I find this an invaluable tool. It's very similar to doing something like looking at your drawing upside down or looking at it in a mirror. Various tools that people, that artists have of checking their work to make sure that what they've put down so far is correct before they go on and start doing all of the rendering. Because if you do the rendering over bad lines, you're going to come out with a lot of effort put into something that's just always going to look a little bit wonky. So it's much better to check your work at this point before you go any further. So you can see here that when you compare the drawing to the photo, when they're approximately the same size, you can tell pretty easily that there are some issues going on. My proportions aren't right. Like, my cup is a little off, the handle is definitely off. There are some issues with the cylinder. The angles on the cube are off. So those are all things that I want to fix before I go any further with shading. So now I'm going back and using the comparison between my photo of my setup and my drawing so far. I'm going back in and into my drawing and making those adjustments to get my drawing more correct. So here I'm introducing compressed white charcoal. Because the paper is a light gray tone, the paper itself serves as our medium light value. And so in order to add a highlight or values lighter than that medium light, I use the white charcoal. It's also really important to remember that these are white objects in front of a black background, so you need to make sure that you're managing your values correctly so that the objects appear white and the background appears black. All of the objects should be lighter than, even the darkest area on the white object should be lighter than the lightest area on the black backdrop. That managing those values correctly will help the objects read as white and the backdrop to read as black.